Good morning, everyone. We are going to continue with our chapter number 3, software architectural styles. Okay. In last sessions, we have seen what is architectural styles, what is architecture. Okay, basics regarding software architectural styles. And we have seen one of architectural style, that is pipes and filters. Okay, we have seen pipes and filters and batch sequential style. Okay, so today we are going to continue with our architectural styles. So we have seen that object oriented organization and data abstraction also. Third one is event-based implicit invocation style. Okay, so this style is suitable for applications that involve loosely coupled collection of components. Okay, so each of which carries out some operations and may in the process enable other operations. Okay, whenever any events occurs, it will trigger the system. Okay, so it is particularly useful for applications that must be recognize on the fly. Okay, so like changing a server service provider, that means this is the event. Okay, changing a service provider, enabling or disabling capabilities. Okay, so in this, instead of invoking a procedures directly, okay, instead of invoking a procedures directly, we can, a component can announce or broadcast one or more events. Okay, here that components can announce one or more events so that it will invoke it, or it will invoke that procedures. Okay, so or other components in the system can register an interest in an event by associating a procedure with the event. Okay, so what that here you can see the procedures. Okay, procedures can also associated with that event. Whenever any events occurs or components can generate an event, it will call that procedures. Okay, here you can see when an event is announced. Okay, when an event is announced, the broadcasting system, like connectors here, see the broadcasting system. Okay, this is the connector. Okay, whenever any event is announced, the broadcasting system connects itself. Okay, invokes all the procedures that have been registered for that particular event. Okay, if that event is registered with that any procedure, okay, then that connector, that means that broadcasting system will call or invoke that procedures or multiple procedures regarding that event. Okay, so an event announced implicitly that calls the invocation of procedures in the models. Okay, here you can see the multiple procedures are, or the event is triggered. Okay, so that broadcasting system will call that procedure. Okay, that is event based implicit invocation. So there are some implicit invocation invariants are there. So like announcer of events do not know which components will be affected by those events. So the announcer of that event or the user of that system, whenever the event is generated, that announcer don't know about which components will be affected by those events. Okay, then the components cannot make assumptions about order of processing, means order of processing of that event. Components cannot make any assumptions like that the priority of that event, that means first will it will admit that event or second will be first. Okay, so that assumptions, components cannot make that assumptions for processing. Okay, then components cannot make assumptions about what processing will occur as a result of their events. Whenever any result is generated and procedure is called by the broadcasting system, then components cannot make any assumptions like what that processing will occur or what is the effect of that process. Okay, what happened? Okay, then there are some specializations, implicit invocation specializations are there. Okay, so here you can see often connectors in implicit invocation system includes the traditional procedure calls. If the specialization is, it includes the traditional procedure calls between that announcement and procedures calls. Okay, so there is a binding between that event announcement and procedure calls. Here you can see the procedures calls, whenever any event occur, that connectors, that is broadcasting system, will call that procedures. Okay, the specialization here is it uses a traditional procedure calls. Okay, so there are some examples of implicit invocations, like it is used in programming environments to integrated tools like debuggers, okay, editors. Here you can see in debuggers, it stops at a breakpoint. Whenever we are going to set a breakpoints in debugger, if you have seen, then the debugger stops at a breakpoint and makes that announcement. Okay, so there is error here or there is a mistake at that point. Okay, so we are going to set that breakpoint. So that means we are going to generate the events. Okay, so in editor responds to the announcement by scrolling to the appropriate source line of the program and highlight that line. Okay, after setting that breakpoint, debugger announces that this is the at this line, at this breakpoint you are missing something, okay, or there is any event or there is any error. That time editor will respond to that announcement by scrolling with appropriate scroll line and it will highlight that line. Okay, then it used to enforce integrity constraint in database management system. That means call the triggers. Whenever we are going to set any triggers, that it generates events or it creates an event. Whenever we are going to call the triggers, it will execute that events again and again. Okay, then there are some advantages of event based implicit invocation style. Okay, so what are the advantages? It provides strong support for reuse. Okay, it provides strong support to reuse, since any component can be introduced into a system simply by registering it for the event of the system. Okay, so we can reuse any component so that whenever system generates or registers for any event, we can reuse that procedures. Okay, so it is easy system. Is a system evaluation, since components may be replaced by other components without affecting the interfaces of the components in the system. We can easily replace any component without affecting any interfaces of that system, okay, or any components of the system. These are the advantages of event-based implicit invocation style. Okay, so there are some disadvantages. Okay, what are that? That components announces that when any component announces or generates an event, it has no idea what other components will respond to it. Okay, whenever any component generates any event, then that component don't have any idea that how other components will respond to that event or what are the effect of that event to other components. Okay, so it cannot rely on the order in which the responses are invoked. Okay, so that components or that events are not rely on the in which order they are going to be executed or they are going to be called. Okay, so it cannot know the when processes or responses are finished. Okay, so these are some advantage or disadvantages of event based implicit invocations. Okay, so next style is layer systems. Okay, next one is layer systems. You will see the layer systems. Okay, here you can see the examples of layer style. Here you can see the virtual machine for Java. Here you can see the virtual machines style. Okay, here you can see the procedure calls. Okay, there are multiple procedure calls. Here you can see, yeah, setup procedures. Okay, these are the setup procedures and these are the procedure calls. In this example, you can see here, these are the setup procedures and these are the procedure calls. Okay, here you can see the Java, then operating system, then processor. Okay, so these are the setup procedures. Okay, and these are the procedure calls to that system. Okay, these are the multiple layers for Java virtual machine. Okay, this is the layer style here. What is layer style here? In layer system, it is organized in hierarchical manner. Okay, here you can see the hierarchy of that Java virtual machines. Okay, each layer providing service to the layer above and below. Okay, here you can see that there are multiple layers are there. They are providing services to the above layer or the below layer. Okay, then what are the components and connectors in layer system style? In layer system style, the components are programs or sub programs deployed in a layer. Okay, the programs or sub programs are components in layer system style. Okay, then connectors. What are the connectors in layer system style? Protocols. Protocols are the connectors in layer system cells. Protocols in the sense procedures calls or system calls. Okay, so these are the connectors in layer system styles. So what are the stylistics in variants? Okay, so in this, each layer provides a service only to the immediate layer above or below. Okay, it provides the services to above layer or upper layer or below layer. Okay, so here you can see the another example of layer system, that is OSI protocol stack. Here you can see there are seventh layer, that is application, physical, session layer, transport layer, network layer, and data link and physical layer. All these layers are providing services to their upper layer or their below layer. Okay, so data, here you can see the application layer, presentation layer providing services to application layer. Okay, so these are the several layers that provide services to upper and below layer. Okay, so what are the advantages of layer system? First one is decomposability. Okay, what is decomposability? Effective separation of concerns and different level of abstractions. Different level of abstractions are at upper layer and at below layer. Okay, then maintainability. Changes that do not affect layer interfaces are easy to maintain. Okay, then adaptability or portability. It can replace inner layers as long as interface remain the same. Then understandability. So there are some disadvantages of layer systems. Okay, so if there are multiple layers are there, then their performance degrades. Okay, it can be difficult to cleanly assign functionality to right layer. If multiple layers are there, that performance get degrades. Okay, this is the disadvantage of layer system. Okay, you can see the example, we have seen the OSI reference models example. Okay, then next style is repository style. Okay, repository styles. Okay, so in repository style, okay, we are having shared data. So it is very common in information systems where data is shared among different functions. Okay, so in repository style, it is shared data store with two variants. Okay, with two variants. First one is repository style and second one is blackboard style. Okay, so what repository style is, the participating parties check the data store for changes. Okay, in blackboard style, the data store alerts the participating parties whenever there is a data store change or any triggers. Okay, here you can see that this is a shared data, patient database, shared data. Who can access this? These are the units who can access that shared data. Here, example, patient database, physician, pharmacy and drug processing unit, lab testing unit, and accounting and administration. All these units can access this shared data. Okay, so here you can see the repository architecture. There are multiple agents who can access that repository. Okay, so here you can see the repository style. It is suitable for applications in which central issue is establishing, augmenting, and maintaining a complex central body of information. Here you can see the shared data is there. There are multiple agents or multiple units are there who can access that shared data, who can access that repository. Okay, so what are the components and connectors here? Components in repository style is a central data structure representing the current state of the system. Okay, this is the central data structure who represent the current state of the system. Then a collection of independent components that operate on the central data structure. These are the components in repository styles. Okay, what are the connectors here? Procedure calls or direct memory access. Okay, these are the how we can access that data through procedure calls or through memory access or direct memory access, we can access this shared data. Okay, this is the repository style. So what are the specializations here? Changes to the data structure triggers the computation. Okay, then data structure in memory, that is persistent operation options are there, data structures on disk, okay. Then concurrent computation and data accesses, these are the specialization of these styles, okay. So there are some examples of repositories like information system, programming environments, graphical editors, okay. Through that we can share the data and access that data, okay. So there are some advantages of these styles and some disadvantages of this. So what are the advantages here? Efficient way to store large amount of data in shared or in repository. We can store the large amount of data in efficient way, okay. Then sharing model is published as the repository schema, okay. We can share that data with multiple agents. Then centralized management is there, that means we can backup, provide security. There is concurrency control is there, okay, in shared style, in repository style, okay. Then what are the disadvantages of this style? Here must agree on a data model or a priori, okay. That means it is derived by logic without observed facts. Then difficult to distribute the data. How the data is distributed or multiple access by multiple agents, okay. Then data evolution is expensive to store that large amount of data, okay. This is all about a repository style, okay. Then next one is blackboard style, okay. This is under shared data, blackboard style. Here you can see the blackboard style, okay. Here you can see the blackboard, shared data is there, okay. Here what is blackboard style? This style is characterized by central data structure. Here you can see the central data structure, or that is shared data is there, okay. And a collection of components operating on the central data store. There are multiple components are there who can operate on that data, okay. So it is characterized by three main types of components, okay, which are there. So those components are knowledge sources, that is KS. Here you can see the KS1, KS2, KS3, okay. These are the knowledge sources. What are that? Which are independent modules that contain the knowledge needed to solve the problems, okay. That knowledge sources, the independent modules, okay, that contain some knowledge needed to solve this problems. Here we are going to design any style, so we are going to design any architecture. For that we are going to use multiple styles from that blackboard, one of these, okay. This style is contains three main parts, that is knowledge sources which help to solve the problems by their knowledge, okay. Second component is blackboard, okay, which is global repository containing input data and partial solutions. What that blackboard contains, okay, it contains the partial solutions for that problems, okay. Then third one is controller. Controller is responsible for managing the course of problem solving, that is it coordinates with different knowledge sources, okay. Controller is communicating with different knowledge sources. Here you can see controller, blackboard and knowledge sources, okay. This is the blackboard style. Here what are the connectors? Here these are the components, okay. Knowledge source, blackboard and controller, these are the components of this type. And connectors here, blackboard is the connector between, that is shared data repository or possibly with finite capacity. Here you can see this is the connector here, okay. And these are the components, okay. So what is property of this style is different KS, different knowledge sources may not communicate directly, okay. Here this knowledge sources may not communicate directly with this shared data or with this blackboard, okay. This is the property of this style, okay. So there are some advantages and disadvantages of this style is there. First one is advantages. First one advantage is simplicity, okay. That means only one connector that everyone uses, that means blackboard, okay. Only one connector is there. Here you can see only one connector is there who can communicate with components, okay. Then evolvability, new types of components can be added easily. We can add easily, new components can be added easily, okay. Then disadvantages, there will be problem of bottleneck when there are multiple clients, okay, or many clients are there, then the problem of bottleneck may be occurred in blackboard style, okay. So here you can see the example of Facebook, Google Docs. Okay, there are multiple agents, multiple components are there who can access the shared data. Who can access that repository. Okay, this is the example of Blackboard style. Okay. See here, Blackboard share data, multiple knowledge sources are there. Okay, so today we have seen three styles. Okay, first one is event based implicit invocation style. Okay, event based, here you can see the event based invocation style. Then we have seen layer styles. Then we have seen the examples of that styles. Okay, then we have seen the repository styles. Okay, that is for shared data. There are two styles. First one is repository, another one is Blackboard style. Okay, so today we have seen four styles of software architectural styles. Okay, so that's it for today's session. Thank you.